From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Westbrook's Pike Industries has learned that it can go ahead with its blasting plans. That's after a judge on Monday approved a consent order to allow Pike to mine its quarry. Earlier this month, nearby businesses Artel and Smiling Hill Farms tried to block the agreement between Pike and IDEX Laboratories that sets limits on Pike's mining operation. Former Auburn school teacher convicted on two counts of transporting a minor across state lines with the intent to engage in sexual activity has filed an appeal. Earlier this month, a federal judge sentenced James Raymond to 12 years in prison after finding him guilty of taking an 11-year-old student and her younger sister to Canopy Lake Park in New Hampshire at least twice. The appeal could take several months before a decision is made. For the final time, members of the Portland City Council have selected the city's next mayor. Their selection is a familiar name. Nick Mavadonis will serve as mayor for a second consecutive term, but only after Councilor Cheryl Lehman turned down the nomination. This will be the last time that councilors select the mayor, because earlier this month, Portland voters decided that they wanted to elect the mayor starting next year. Currently, the city mayor only serves a one-year term, but starting next year, the mayor elected by voters will serve 4 years and be limited to no more than two-year terms. Governor-elect Paul LePage will hold a press conference Tuesday to announce the formation of his transition advisory team. The 40-member bipartisan team will include leaders from the private and public sectors from all corners of Maine. About 1,000 applications have been turned in for about 150 jobs in the new administration. Members of the team will provide input into policy proposals for LePage and help identify the skill sets and characteristics needed to fill key positions in the administration. Some big donations Monday for Maine's Good Shepherd Food Bank. At their Portland warehouse, a delivery truck arrived with boxes of food for Maine's needy families. Not only was the food donated, but the truck itself and a check for $100,000. The Walmart Foundation made that donation. Meanwhile, the Salvation Army families were picking up their Thanksgiving food baskets. 300 families signed up for baskets this year. That is a 10% increase. One woman says these baskets make a big difference for her family.
It makes a difference for a lot of us because everybody's hurting right now with the economy. I'm like currently unemployed and my unemployment runs out and stuff. So I know a lot of people that need help.
Charitable organizations are struggling to meet the needs of Maine's hungry. They say the statistics are just getting worse. 2 years ago, officials say there were 140,000 Mainers who needed food assistance. That number has jumped to 195,000 this year. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.